Hello everyone, it's me, LinkingX2, back with more daily MSI content, now covering the probably deciding match in Group A between Unicorns of Love and Pentanet.gg. Let's get right into the draft here. So, as you can see, we already see the first ban here on the blue side for the Udyr, so this makes it so that the priority of junglers like the Rumble and the Morgana are even higher for potential trades on the red side here. On the other side, we see the Senna ban. It has been something that the UOL team has prioritized quite a bit, as they are more known for more scaling champions. Then we see also the Morgana ban, which is even more confusing on the blue side, as it is a very, very strong jungler at the moment. Probably the strongest, if you ask me. The Rumble obviously has a bit more damage, but lesser clear speed. So yeah, you usually want to first pick that on the blue side, as it's also a flex pick, so you can't even get the counter pick that hard. Then we see the Nocturne coming in, obviously a flex pick for many positions. Even the jungle, as Arnautschik has played the champion in his career over and over again. Then we see the Rumble ban as well. So that obviously denies the first pick after the strongest junglers are being taken away here. So that's a ban that has to come in. But it's also not too hard for them, because they, on the red side, do kind of expect to ban the Rumble here. The Gnar ban, sorry, is a bit strange though, as it's usually not a super contested champion. Biopanda has played him a bit though, so yeah, it's a free ban that they need to, or like, want to throw at the top lane. They're first picking Analchix Nidalee, it seems like. So that's, yeah, one of the AP junglers that now comes to mind after all these bans. So yeah, this enables usually more AD mid and top laners. So that's a bit strange, as Nomance is not really known for too many AD mid laners. But yeah, also Nidalee obviously a faster paced jungler than the game plan you from UOL usually indicates, as they're more, yeah, a scaling team in comparison to Pentanet, who, yeah, are more fast paced in comparison, of course, as the meta is rather slow at the moment. So just to note, mention again, this is a very important match for both teams, as RNG has already made it out of the groups, and they're now fighting for the last spot here. So this is not for fun. And the Nautilus here, Nautilus against Nidalee, it's a good pick, as Nidalee can't really outkite his point and click. But it's a bit silly to pick the support so early on. They're not match picking here, and they're not really flex picking either. Renekton, yes, can go into the mid lane in some cases. And Jazz is probably a player of that caliber who can do this, as he is playing quite a few spicy champions. On the other side, the Alistar versus the Nautilus. This is a bread and butter champion matchup that has been played over and over in the past. So that's nothing too surprising. And also for Santas, if you have followed the player for a while, his Alistar is something he's quite comfortable with. The Urgot here into the Renekton instead of the Darius. So Darius would be quite foolish, as Renekton has always been a counter to him, even since 2015, where the Juggernaut meta was in full effect. So here the Urgot works decently with the Nidalee in 2v2s, but yeah, it's a good top lane champion if you are going for a bit more blind, as champions that counter him like Karma or the Irelia are not being played. And with Gnar also being banned, that's something of an annoying matchup gone. Also Renekton probably going into top lane, so you don't have to worry about too much there with GP or something. That could be also a poorer matchup top. We see here lastly the Kai'Sa being elected, so that's something. Kai'Sa with Nautilus, obviously a lot of upfront burst, as Nautilus can apply many passive stacks of plasma, and then yeah, she can proc it very easily. And against Nidalee, that's quite good. The others are a bit more on the tankier side, so the common Kai'Sa build with Collector second won't be too great here. And overall, I don't really like Kai'Sa here versus these enemy champions. Nidalee is not an issue for most AD carries or any, but the other two, as she's quite short range, this is not too amazing. So yeah, she really is looking to dive into the enemy backline, but we don't even know the backline. So if they ban Zaya, yes, and if there are Zaya or Tristana, that could be very bad to dive into because you lose the 1v1 quite handily. But yeah, they make use of the R3 pick here, as I talked around, as I talked about it in my autodraft series, where you can find a link in either of these corners. The R3 pick can be really set up with these bans here, and these two bans already do kind of indicate that line of thought. These two, or especially the Varus, is more for the laning phase, while the Zaya would be a more a team fight issue for the Kai'Sa here. On the other side, the Diana. So maybe that's a pocket pick that I am not informed about. Then with the little sticks, so maybe I have slept on something, but these AP junglers here, maybe they're the next in priority. After Morgana, Nidalee, and the Rumble being gone. So yeah, you might expect these to come up after some scrim or solo queue research. And next to the Renekton, yeah, AP junglers would have been a bit better than the Graves that is being hovered right now. But Graves here with the Renekton, so they are high on AD. So yeah, these two champions here are already super tanky. So they can go more against these short range AD champions here with their next picks. But what I want to mention here again, if the Renekton should go into top lane, which we assume at this point, he with his AP damage hopefully will be the sole source of AP damage. So that's the responsibility for DPS will increase on his part. We see here from UOL, very smart here with their champions. So Tristana, Orianna, that is always super dangerous for the enemy team to go into, and especially if the engage is not very fast. So Malphite ultimate would be fast, but a Renekton slice and dicing in, that's comparably slow. So yeah, these champions are already good against this softer engage, and also again against the short range, these two champions obviously with high range. Then the CC and slows in the front line. Let's take that a bit. So their comp already looking against these four enemy champions and to do quite a lot. I really like what UL has here. The Nidalee is a bit of an issue. I don't like that. She's not really doing anything. She's actually hurting her team. The top lane 2v2 is already fine. And mid lane 2v2s now will be a bit of an issue with double AP here. So that's a bit hurtful, but it's probably a bit more on the comfortable side for Ananachik, as they have banned out quite a few junglers, to be honest. So they were looking for a favorable jungle matchup. And Nidalee into Graves, it is decent, as Graves' E passive is not giving him magic resistance for quite a while now. And in terms of farm speed, obviously, she is very strong. Then, Vest gets the Ahri here. So that's not really the DPS they're looking for. So that's not great. That's not great. The Ahri is not doing anything here. The Ahri is more on the line of thought for early skirmishing, which is what we expect from Pentanet.gg. They're more the faster paced team here. But they're now really hard on the clock. So top lane, jungle, and mid lane as well will be compositionally outscaled here by what UOL has crafted overall. And yeah, even though Kai'Sa does scale in comparison or versus UOL, that's not a factor at all. So yeah, they are on the clock. But to be honest, their early and mid game is still very strong. The mid lane 2v2 will be astronomically better here. Graves with an AP mid laner, also an AP mid laner that has CC, most notably the Syndra matchup, always has been very good. But Ahri, yeah, with her charm, similar effect. So yeah, they can make use of this pressure they will be able to generate in the mid lane here. Bot lane though, matchup is not looking all too good here. And top lane, yeah, Kogod is usually a brick, a wall that can't be moved. So yeah, it's quite tough for them. But if they were able to get good drakes, good drake control early on, there's a chance, right? Snowball comps do occasionally work, but they have to play very, very good and have to make really good use of their mid lane 2v2. Other than that, yeah, I would give the huge advantage here in draft for UL. Yes, the their team hates the Nidalee, as she is a liability for their win condition in the later stages. But overall, very solid. They have a lot of different damage sources. They have CC, they have the long range to counteract their short range, and they have CC and slows, as well as, how would you describe it, counteract tools for their forwardness. So in terms of champion colors, these are very blue champions, not only in terms of scaling, but also in terms of terrain control. And their champions are red, so they are forward in nature. So yeah, they get normally countered by this. The question, if we have a red versus blue in terms of comps, is there enough white on the blue side to hold up against the red? Which means, do they have the ability to hold out in the early game versus the aggression on the other side? And in my personal opinion, that is absolutely the case here. Urgot, as I mentioned, he's a brick, and making use of the top lane layout on the blue side will be completely safe even against the aggression the Renekton has. And even if he should be set behind, he will always be somewhat useful. But he has to then go for a more tankier approach in his item build. That shouldn't be fine, as they have a lot of damage in their mid AD carry duo. Talking about mid lane, Orianna versus Ahri, that's a matchup, as very old matchup. So yeah, even though after level 6 it will be a bit more annoying for her. Overall though, with the item breakpoints and instant wave clear, it should be able to be played out quite safe. So it will be a bit hard, especially as I mentioned, the strength of Pentanet's comp is the mid jungle 2v2. So that will be the point where they seek to attack them. But then later in the bot lane down below, it's also super fine. Yes, Tristana is a bit of a champion that can fall down in the mid game after a poor laning phase, but that's something that they obviously can hold out through for the later stages. And Alistar, a great defensive bot laner here for her AD carry, for his AD carry. So yeah, even down below they are quite safe. But overall, Pentanet's aggression is not like most likely being able to penetrate UOL. The UOL here with the draft edge, should they be able to identify that they just need to wait 27-30 minutes and then just win based on their better champions, unless Pentanet can rush dragons, get the soul early on, and then with a mountain soul or an ocean soul, they might be able to win later fights. But that's not something that we can expect, as it's based on RNG and other factors that are a bit more gameplay dependent. But that's it for the draft review here. So let's move to that screen. Yeah, so that's it. Thank you all for coming by. Let me know in the comments down below, what do you think of this draft? Do you think UL has the advantage here? And also let me know if you have any other matchups that I should talk about. As I said, daily MSI content. So yeah, in the following days, we will see each other again. Till then, I wish you all a great day.